Welcome back to this module 3 of Digital System Design, okay, under VTUE Shikshana program. So we'll continue with the flip-flop and its application. And in the last class, you have seen the gated JK working and all, okay. So now, all these latches, or what we call it as a flip-flops, starting from SR latch using NOR or SR latch using NAND, and then going with the gated SR latch, then the DIF latch, and now the gated JK latch. All these are flip-flops, but all these we are told that they are all level sensitive. So one class of flip-flops are latches which are level sensitive, and this is what exactly we are trying to see today. So this gated JK latch or SR latch, all are level sensitive. Okay, so this is what is very important to understand for us now. Okay, so they are all level. We'll try to see what exactly I mean by this level sensitive and all about. Okay, so this is what we try to do today along with other timing diagrams. Okay, so latches, predominantly they are level sensitive. Okay, what is that level sensitive? We'll try to see now. Okay, so that's what we will try to do now. Basically, now we are trying to analyze this particular flip-flops. Especially, I'll go with the gated JK latch. Okay, where we will try to understand what is the level sensitive is all about. Okay, and why we call the gated latch as a level sensitive. And you know that there is a signal E. Okay, so this is what I mean by E. This is what I mean by E. Okay, so what I'll try to do is I'll try to give a continuous pulses, clock pulses, what you call this as, okay, with the 50% duty cycle, meaning on 50% on means 50% off. Okay, so this is what I'll try to do now. Okay, so this is what, so correspondingly, so this is zero and this is something like logic one or VCC, what you call, okay, lower level and the higher level. And this x-axis is predominantly will be my time. Okay, this is time, whereas my y-axis, okay, this will be with respect to my magnitude. What magnitude here? It is nothing but what? Voltage level. Okay, so the magnitude will be my x-axis and my y-axis will be the time. Okay, so this is the E. So this enable will be 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, and 1 something. Okay, so now, so one, whenever this enable is 1, then only we will tell that this is enabled, and then it depends upon JK, and accordingly I'll get the output. Okay, so now I'll try to take the values for J and K. Okay, this is what I'll try to do now. Okay, J, initially J is 0. Next it becomes 1 and it will remain 1 till this point. Next it becomes 0, next it becomes 1 somewhere at this point, then it is continuously 1 something. Then K, okay, so initially again it will be 0 and it will continue to be 0 at some point, then it becomes 1. Okay, this is what I have. Then it will be 1 and then it will continuously become 1. This is what I'm trying to do now. Okay, this is 0 and this is 1, this is 0, this is 1. Now this is 0 here also it is 0, here it is 1, here it is 1, and here also it is something like 1. This is what is really happening now. Okay, now we'll try to see how exactly my output changes. That's what I mean by Q. Okay, so now here we are interested in whenever E is equal to 1. Okay, so this is the time period. Okay, so now what we'll try to do is we'll try to take this particular time point as T naught. Okay, this is what I'll try to do. So T naught is the time at which E is becoming 1. Okay, and before that E was disabled. The moment E is 0 means this is disabled. Q assume that previously it will be 0 only. Okay, so before the first enable occurs, my previous Q will be 0. Okay. Now, at t time t naught, E is becoming 1, and the corresponding J value is 1 and K value 0. And when J1, K0 is there, I know that output will be set. So previous is 0. At time t naught, my output becomes sets. And you can see that until this time, or until my E is 1, J is not changing as well as K is not changing. So what I'll try to do is till this point. So I'll take this timing points with respect to my E. Okay, so this will be useful for us in analyzing the timing diagram along with the output. Okay. So till between T naught to T1, E is 1, J is 1, K0, I can say that Q will be set. This is what I mean by K is set, because flip-flop or JK latch is enabled. Okay, enabled, J is 1, K0. Next, from T1 till T2, okay, so T1 to T2, what is happening? E is 0. The moment E is 0 means this is disabled. Disabled means my output will have the previous. So the output between T1 to T2 will follow the previous. So T1 to T2 output previous will be T1 to T0. So it will continue till T2. Okay. Next, for the second time, E is becoming 1. The moment E is 1, flip-flop is enabled. J0 K1. So when J0 K1, output should go 0, or output becomes reset. Okay, it will reset. Okay, it will go. And now you can see that for the second time. So now for the complete, so I'll take with this particular thing. So this is T3, and you can see that between time T2 and T3, even though my enable is 1, J and K are not fixed. Okay, so J is 0 for some time, this time, okay, whereas K is remaining same. Clear? So J was 0, K was 1, output was set. But at time, sometime between T2 and T3, J is becoming 1 now. J1, K1 means what? Output should be complement of previous. Okay, so this is what we are seeing here. Okay, so now at this time, okay, in between T2 and T3, my output is becoming 1. Okay, this is what. That means whenever E is 1, okay, any change in JK, output also changes. That means output is changing with respect to change in the input J and K for the levels of this E. And that's what we mean by level sensitive. This is what we mean by level sensitive. Okay. This is level sensitive. Okay. Level sensitive. This is what we call it as level sensitive. Okay. Meaning my output is changing for the complete one level of my E. Okay. Clear? Now, this is one thing. Next, you can see that after this, between T2 and T3, immediately, so I call this as something like, okay, this is another point. Then immediately after this, if I go with this respect to this point, if I go with this this point now, it is some other T between T2 and T3. Again, my J and K are 1-1. At this point, J and K are 1-1. Again, after some point, sometime, my J and K are 1-1 still. So, again, my output should be complement, meaning at this point, my output should go as 1 now. It was 1, next it should become 0. And then this continues now. Okay. And between T3 and T4, okay, since E is 0, flip-flop is disabled, assuming that this particular Q has stopped at this point, it will remain 1. If not, if Q was at 0, it would have retained 0. Okay, so this is what we mean by, okay. Two things we are trying to see here. One is, my output is changing for the complete one level of E. That's why it is called level sensitive. Okay, so that's why this latch is called as level sensitive. This is level sensitive. Okay. If someone asks you, what is a latch? You should be in a position to tell that it is a level sensitive. Big meaning, whenever flip-flop is enabled for the enable input being 1, okay, yes, my output will continuously change with respect to input. That is 1. Next, you can see here, when E was 1 and when JK is 1, 1, 1, 1, you can see that output is not stable. From 0 it becoming 1, from 1 it becoming 0. And this particular variation, when E is equal to 1, when E is equal to 1, and J as well as K are 1, as well as J and K are 1, my output, even though I get a valid output, but it is not stable, it is varying. And this particular thing that is happening in the gated JK latch, when E is 1 and when both J and K are 1, 1, my output is going between 0, 1, 0, 1, it will be altering. And this particular condition, we call it as a race around condition. Okay, what is this? We call this particular thing as a race around condition. Okay, so that's why even though we have overcome the problem of having SR11 in JK, JK11 output is complement of previous. But since it is a level sensitive, when JK11 and when enable is 1, my output won't be in a stable condition, either 0 stable condition or 1 logic 1. It will be racing around between 0 and 1. And this is happening for 1/2 period when E is equal to 1. And this particular condition wherein JK both 1 and E is 1 and my output of JK latch is just continuously changing from 0, 1 or 1, 0 or 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, we call that particular thing as race around condition. So even though we have overcome a problem that was there in SR latch, but still another problem exists in gated JK latch, that is race around condition. Okay, in order, this is what is about the level sensitive, and level sensitive is common for all the other latches like D latch, SR latch using NAND or gated latch, all these are one and the same for me. Yes, but in the gated JK latch, along with the level sensitive latch, which we call it as, the other problem that persists in JK gated latch is race around condition. So in order to overcome this race around condition, okay, in order to overcome this particular race around condition, we either use pulse triggered flip-flop. That's what the second type category of flip-flop. Either we go with a pulse triggered, okay, either we go with the pulse triggered or edge triggered. Okay, these are the other two classes of flip-flops. Okay, one class of flip-flop is latch. It is a level sensitive, and just now we saw what I mean by level sensitive. Level sensitive means output will vary with respect to the inputs until my enable is 1. This is what I mean by level. Okay, when E is at 1 level, that is 1, output changes with continuously with respect to change in inputs. And when it is at 0 level, output is not changing because my flip-flop is or latch is disabled. Okay, that is what I mean by level sensitive. Why we go for pulse triggered and edge triggered, okay, reason is being, okay, this particular race around condition of JK. We'll try to go with pulse triggered and JK triggered. Okay. So before we move on to the pulse triggered and edge triggered flip-flops, okay, which are the other two classes of flip-flop, we'll try to see some of the timing diagrams that persist here. Okay. Okay. So the timing concentration is another important aspect in any flip-flops. When using a real flip-flop, the following information is needed to be considered. One is the propagation delay. This is very important. People might ask you, what do you mean by a propagation delay? It is nothing but what? Time needed for an input signal to produce an output signal. That's it. Okay? Time taken for an input signal to produce an output signal, it is the propagation delay. Next is minimum pulse width. Minimum amount of time a signal must be applied. I can't simply trigger a circuit, okay? My input should be valid for some minimum amount of time. Okay, that's what we mean by minimum pulse width. Then, setup and hold time. And the setup and hold time is exclusive for D flip-flops. Okay, this is exclusive for D flip-flops, or it may be latches also. Okay, so D flip-flops are latches, exclusive. But propagation delay for all the flip-flops. Okay, so what I mean by setup and hold time? Minimum time the input signal must be held fixed before and after the latching action. The minimum amount of time the input signal must be held fixed before latching action is setup time. Minimum time the input signal must be held fixed after the latching action is hold time. These are the definitions of propagation delay, the minimum pulse width, and the setup and hold time. Okay, this is what we come. So propagation delays in an SR latch. Okay, so whenever we take any signal, okay, so even though in my previous timing diagram I had shown something like this, right, the transition from low to high is very fast, within no time it happens, but typically, practically, it won't be. Practically it will be something like this. It takes some time to reach from 0 to 1, and again it takes some time to reach from high to low. So time taken for the input to rise from 10% of the signal to 90% of the signal, we call this particular period as rise time. Okay, this is what we call it as a rise time. This is rise time. Again, we'll try to define along with the propagation delay what is I mean by rise time. And again, the time taken for the input to fall from 90% to 10%. Okay, this timing I mean by. Okay, this timing. And this particular time, we call it as fall time. This is what? This is my fall time. This is my fall time. Okay. So time taken for the input to have a transition from 10% or a signal from 10% to reach from 10% to 90%, we call it as rise time. And a signal to fall from 90% to 10%, we call it as a fall time. These are the two things along with the propagation delay. Now, this is how S is varying. This is how R is varying. Okay. So correspondingly, how exactly output is now changing? You can see that this is exactly midpoint. That is the 50% I mean by. Okay. You can see that assuming my enable is 1. Okay. That means SR flip-flops or latches enabled now. And initially Q is 0. And I know that Q bar is 1. The moment Q is 0, Q bar should be 1. S was 0, R was 0. So I don't have any problem. S and R both 0, 0. Output will be previous, and previous it is, we are assuming to be 0. Now E is 1 and S is having a transition from low to high. Okay. And R is remaining 0 only. The moment S is 1, R is 0, my output should set now. Okay, so from 0 it should become 1. And you can see that even though s is going from 0 to 1, and you can see the 50% change at s at this particular point. What is this? The dotted one. Okay. But my output will reach that 50% of set only after some time. And this some time is what we call it as something like a propagation delay. Is this clear now? This is what we mean by the propagation delay. So you can see that s is becoming, taking a 50% here, and that in order to change the output to 50%, it takes some time. And this time, what is elapsed, okay, in order for output to set, even though the s is 1 and r is 0, well, before the time, that time we call it as a propagation time. The propagation time is same, okay, with respect to the q as well as q bar. So when q is changing from 0 to 1, q bar is moving from 1 to 0. This is what really happening. And now, the other thing. Here, after some time, my r is becoming 1, s is becoming 0. This is what? 0 and 1. In between, it will be 0 and 1 and 0 only. And again here, reverse. E is still 1. R is 1. S is 0 means output should reset. Again, you can see that R is having a transition from low to high, and it is reaching a 50% of transition here. But you can see output is having that 50% change. That means this change in input is letting the output to change after some time, and this some time is also called as again the propagation delay. Okay, the propagation delay, okay, is with respect to the fall time is typically, okay, takes more time compared to the rise time. Okay, so you can see that these are the propagation delay. Next, timing diagram for an SR latch. Okay, so there we had shown the practical how exactly the variation happens, but here you can see that without any rise time and fall time here. See here, R and S both 0, 0, Q 0, 1. Now, S is becoming 1 here, R is 0. At this point only my Q should become 1, but this is what I mean by the propagation time. Okay, you can see that. Change in the input is changing the output after some time. This is what we mean by propagation delay. This is what we mean by TP. Okay, similarly, you can see all around the case. Okay, this is for different values of SR. And when it becomes 1, 1, you can see what is the changes that is happening. And now, as I said, there are other two delays, that is the setup time and the hold time. Okay, and this setup and hold time is typically for the D. Okay, D latch. Okay, as we saw that setup time is what? Before latch happen occurs, okay, latching action occurs with respect to the D flip-flop, my input should be held before the latching. That is what setup. And what is hold time? My input should be held before, okay, or after the latching completes also. That's what we mean by, okay. You can see that this is my D input. This is my input. This is my input. And this C is something like an enable, okay. This is enable. Even though D is 1 here, my C is 0, this is disabled. Q is reset. Okay. Now, when C is becoming 1, okay, you can see that. And this is what? D is already 1 here. E is enabled. I get output Q. That means it is following D. You can see here. This is what we mean by. At this particular point of E, okay, at this particular point of E, my D is 1. And at this point, I want Q to be 1. But because of the propagation delay, the D is changing. That is, Q is changing after some time. This is what we mean by TP. This is the propagation delay just we saw in the previous case with respect to SR latch also. Okay, now coming to the setup and hold time. You can see that this is where the latching is happening, right? Okay, so input should be valid. This is my input. Input should be input should end, or it should appear before the latching happens. Before this latching happens, input is there. That is what we mean by setup time. And input is still valid, or it is occurring after the latching. Okay, and that is what we mean by hold time. And the same thing, setup and hold time is there whenever the latching is happening with respect to the delatch. Okay, this is what we mean by the setup and hold time. So to have a definition, setup time is the time, minimum time, the input should be held before the latching happens, and the hold time is nothing but what? Minimum time the input should be held after the latching action. Okay, one is before and one is after. This is all about your latches, level sensitive, then what is race around condition, the level, different gates and all. Okay, and now we will try to go, what is this master slave flip-flop? Okay, this is very important for us now in order to understand this. Here in a master slave, we go with two latches. Okay, this is latch one. Okay, this is latch two. Till now we saw only one latches were there, but now we'll try to use two latches. So in master slave there will be two latches. Okay, one is acting as a master. Okay, latch one is master and latch two is slave form. You can see that master and slave. And other thing is, you can see that clock, what we call it as something like an enable. Okay, you can see here uncomplement is going for the first and the complement is going for the second. This is typically C bar, meaning when this is enabled, this is disabled. That means when this clock is 1 means this is 0, and when this is 0 means this is 1. You can see that both the latches won't be enabled simultaneously. Is it clear? Alternately they will be enabled. When master is enabled, slave is disabled, and when slave is enabled, master is disabled. This is the important aspect of master slave flip-flop. Okay, so we'll try to analyze. Okay, what we'll try to do is, now initially, okay, this is one kind of masters and this is another. We'll try to assume output. Initially this is 0 and this is 1. Okay, this is what is really happening. And when this is operating, when I assume that when this is enabled, this will be disabled, we know that. Okay, and when I say Q is 0 and Q bar to be 1, is it not true that S is 0 and R is 1? This is what the truth table of an SR latch is all about, right? When S is 0, R is 1, then only output is reset. And we can see that whatever the output I am getting from the first, the same will be the input for this. Is this clear now what I am saying? Yes, that is what we have to follow now. Okay, so we try to assume Q to be 0, Q bar to be 1 here. Okay, now we'll try to analyze now. Okay, now S is 1, R is 0. This is what we are trying to view now. We are not interested in the master output. For us, the actual output in the master slave is this one. The slave output, what we are getting is the actual output for us. This is what is the actual output for us, not the master. Okay, so when S is 1, R is 0, what this happens? This becomes 1, that is QM is set, QM bar is reset. We know that. We know the truth table of SR latch now. Whenever, so we assume clock is 1, okay, clock is 1, here the clock will be 0. Okay, the clock input for this will be 0. That means the master is enabled, the slave is disabled. Okay, QM is 1, QM bar is 0, and the same values of this will appear here. Not 0, now it will be 1, and this 0 will be appearing at this point. Even though S is changing from previous 0 to 1, and even though R is changing from previous 1 to 0, this won't be changing because C is 0 still now, because when this is enabled, this is disabled means my C is 0. Even though input SR is changing, output is not changing now. Is this clear now? Yes. This is what really is happening now. You can see that. Clock. Okay, we'll try to see what is really happening now. We'll try to just take two aspects, okay? Clock is 0. We'll try to analyze Q now. QM, we'll try to analyze now, okay? Initially, QM was 0. The moment clock comes, and we know that S is 1 and R is 0. Okay? So, S is 1, R is 0. Clock is 1, okay? QM initially was 0. Now, it becomes 1. Yes? I'm not changing my SR in between this. C is equal to 1. Okay? Next, the moment this is 0, this will retain its previous, right? Now we'll try to assume what is Q. Q is nothing but what my QS. The slave output is actual output for me, okay? Initially it was 0, yes? When C is 1, I know that this is enabled, QM will change. When QM changes, the same thing will be my S and R input of the second, but QS, in turn, Q won't be changing because this is disabled. Clear? When C is 1, and what is this complement C bar it is getting? So that's why it will be disabled. So disabled means what? Second flip-flop will be 0 till this point. Is it clear? This is what is happening. And when C becomes 0, that means when C becomes 0, this is disabled, okay, and this is enabled. When this is enabled, you can see that this won't change now, right? So it remains 1, 0. That means this will change, Q becomes 1. Okay? You can see that this is what is happening now. My Q will follow QM after a pulse. After a pulse. That's why it is called as pulse triggered flip-flop now. Okay? Same thing now. For next, when clock is becoming 1, okay, you can, I'll just say, master is enabled here, slave is enabled. Master is enabled, slave is enabled. This is very useful for us, okay. Next, when master is enabled, I make S to be 0, R to be 1, okay. My QM will change from 1 to 0. I'm retaining S and R to be 1 till my this. And then when this becomes 0, I know that this will be disabled, and disabled value is the previous. And when master is set, I know that slave is disabled. And when slave is disabled, it will hold its previous value, that is 1. And the moment master is disabled and slave is enabled, I can see that this is what is happening. Again, you can see it is changing. This is what we call it as ones and zeros catching. Okay, ones and zeros catching. My slave is catching whatever the master is giving. Okay. And the catching is, when it will happen? Only after some pulse. Okay? Only after some pulse. And in master-slave flip-flop, okay, we'll have ones and zeros catching. This is very important aspect. Some might ask you what I mean by ones and zeros catching, and this is what you have to tell them. Okay? Ones and zeros catching. The slave will follow what masters. If master is 1 for half period, in the next half period, the slave will follow the masters. In the next half, it will slave. In the next half, the slave. Okay, you can see that slave will always follow the master. If master was 1, it will become 1. If master is 0, it will become 0 in the next half. So we call it as 1s and 0s catching in master slave. And then, since now, we can see that if you take, this is 1 clock cycle. Okay. My actual output Q is varying when the main clock is going to the second half. That means this is what I am interested in, right? Not this. I am not interested in QM, but I am interested in QS. That is basically Q for me. Yes. And in order for the output to change for the corresponding inputs, okay, I required half pulse here. So that's why this master slave is predominantly called as pulse triggered. This is what, and here we have given clock 0, master disabled, slave enabled. Clock 1, master enabled, slave disabled. And again 0, master disabled, slave enabled. Yeah, it's the same thing I have written here. When clock is 1, master enabled, assuming slave disabled, and this goes on. Okay, master slave flip flop. And now, the whatever that level sensitive is there, it is not happening here. Why means, assume that this QM, slave is enabled, it is catching QM. And QM will never change whenever there is changes happening in the SR. Okay, that is one thing. And when master is enabled, slave is disabled, output will never change with respect to change in my SR. When SR changes, only QM and QM bar will change. And when this is disabled, even though there is a change happening here, this won't change. So that's why this will never become a level sensitive. Okay, master slaves are pulse triggered and they are not level sensitive. And what are the other things that you get? It's the ones and zeros catching. I can overcome the race around condition. Okay. But I will get something called a pulse triggered. And one more concept here is ones and zeros catching. So this is all about your master slave flip-flop, that to SR. Okay, you can see that. Same kind you can see. When both SR 0, 0, clock is 1, this is Q. That is previous. 0, 1, reset. 1, 0, set. 1, 1, it is undefined. When there is no clock signal, okay, irrespective of SR, my output will hold is previous. And these are the corresponding symbols that we have. Okay, this is all about your master slave. Okay, these are all the timing diagrams now. Okay, you can see that when S0, R0, clock 0, I assume that QS is 0, QM is 0, QM bar is 1, and same case will be holding for these things. Okay, now this is, I'll just go with when S. So clock is 1 here, okay, for this period. S is 1, R is 0. S is 1, R is 0. I am not interested in this. I am interested only in this. Okay. QM is becoming 1. I know that only after some time, my Q becomes 1 here. Okay. And Q bar becomes 0. Yes. When S1, R0, provided C is equal to 1, output will set. And this will set after some pulse. Clear? Again now, when clock is 1, S0, R1, QM is 0, QM bar is 1, but this 0 will appear after half period. This is what I mean by zeros and 1 catching. Okay? And in between this, any change is happening, S and R, see, you can see that. When clock is disabled, any change is happening, there is no change happening here. Again, when C is becoming 1, S is 1, R is 0, I know that QM is changing from 0 to 1, but this change is happening at the output only after some time. Okay, you can see that. S1, R0, provided C is equal to 1, output is 1. But after, that's why it is pulse triggered. And same thing continues, and you can see that 1's catching, 0's catching, 1's catching, and again the 0's catching is happening here. So in a master slave, you get ones and zeros catching, and whatever the race around condition was persisting in the latches, that we can overcome in the master slave. And this is all about my master slave flip flop. Okay, so master slave flip flop, and then the application of the flip flop, we'll take it in the next class. Thank you.